Chool Soo Park, University of Colorado, and he'll be talking about manipulation of disc-shaped islands and direct measurements of elastic interaction forces between islands on freely suspended somatic films.
Good afternoon. Thank you for introduction. So my name is Chool Soo Park. So in this talk, I'm going to talk about the manipulations and trappings in two-dimensional system, unlike the other speakers. So the Cha is, he was the graduate student in our group, and then he made a major contribution in this talk. And then Bill Service in display tech, he kindly provided materials. And then this was mostly supported by the NASA grant. Okay, so in Smectic two-dimensional system, and then I give you a brief introduction for the how to make a film, and then how to generate island, and then how to visualize the textures under the microscope, and then how to manipulate using the optical tweezers. And then after that, we just measure elastic interaction force between islands using optical tweezers. And then I briefly introducing that ongoing project using this optical tweezers, and then I'll give you summary at the end. Okay, so at the left top part, so the showing how to make the free suspended film, we just put the material at the edge, and then using the spreader, just pull the material over the hole, and then we get the really nice two-dimensional smectic scene, two-dimensional smectic layers. And then this is the top side view of the island, and then island is a thicker region compared to the background, and then more layers than the background layer. Then this is top view of the island, so the surface, the light tension stabilized at the nice circular shape. Okay, this is the how to make the films, and then what the island is, I showed it. Okay, and then how to make island in some large immersion island, and then we are using two different methods. So one is the airflowing method, and then another is using the inkjet printing. So as you see in this video, we are using the air jet, and then the shear flow, the pull the materials from the meniscus over large size of island to make a small island, and then you get really nice island immersion. And then time goes on, that gives really nice changing behavior. I will go into that topic later. And then how to visualize, this is very long, the depolarized reflective light microscope. And then we are illumination from the side, and then we get the reflective view under the cross polarizer. This is the very nice cross one defect under this microscope. And then the thickness is measured using that reflectivity of the films. And then then finally go into that optical trapping cell. So we have three systems here. One is using the 1064 laser, we are using 532 green laser to illuminate the films. And then we have optical tweezer. As Kishan introduced several different methods, but we are using the post optic diffractor to manipulate to make the multiple trappings. And then we have another setup is to measure the thickness of the film. So this is a brief introduction of the multiple trapping, CU, and then the time sharing the multiple optical trapping, just demonstration. Okay, and then second question is that unlike the other experiment, we are using the two-dimensional disc-shaped island, so whether you can trap or manipulate that disc-shaped island. So we just using the simple theory to calculate the electromagnetic energy changes due to that presence of the dielectric medium, and then we calculate the energy changes, and then the force is that the gradient of this energy. This is the calculation result, and then this shows that we have all the optical force at the edge of the disk shape, the dielectric medium, and then the force is that is proportional to that intensity, also proportional to the thickness of the layers. Okay, so, and then, yeah, this shows the basically we can trap the island at the edge, right? This shows that. And then, how to calibrate that optical force in that pillars? And then, we are using the hydrodynamic drag forces. So, we just fix the one, the intensity, and then we drag that, how fast we can drag the island, and then this, and then the drag force depends on that. The major intensity is linearly proportional, as you see in the calculation. So we use that, and then we get about 0.02 picometers at about 20 milliwatt laser power. Okay, and then in Smectic C-films, okay, we put the circular influence. Okay, this is a brief history of this project. If you put the circular impedance, and then the, at the boundary we have a strong anchoring, and the molecular line to that the boundary, and then to minimize the energy of this system, and then always minus one defect is accompanied by the inclusions. The distance between the plus one minus one. It's a root 2R. R is that diameter of this, radius of this inclusion. So this is well explained by Lorentzky group. And then later, if you have two inclusions, and then it has a very nice chaining behavior, and then the protocol rule calculate that energy as a function of the separation. And then the minimum, the equilibrium separation is that 2R is, that's very consistent with that first calculation. as I showed, this calculation only just consider the elastic free energy, minimizing the elastic free energy, and then you get the equilibrium. The separation equilibrium state, and then we change the polarization, and then what's happening? So in the if you have a chiral, pure chiral material like 20 nanopolar per centimeter square, and then we get the really rigid the chain behavior, and then this spiral part is very explained by the Bauer-Meyers group. So I'm not going to talk about that. And then if you make the racemic case, and then the interaction force is really weak, and then it's no changing game. And then if you keep changing that chirality, then we get the weaker interaction forces. So with this experiment, we have to clearly include that the polarization term into this calculation. Okay, and then maybe you have to go back again. So how to measure the interaction force between the islands? So so we have only trapping is just the outside. So we just pull the trapping, pull the beams, the trap of one island, and then another island we trap, and then keep getting close, and then the depulsive force is bigger than the trapping force, and then escaped from the trapping, and then we measure the the pores between the, as a function of the separation, we measure that the repulsive force. Also same way we can measure the attractive power. Okay, this is that experimental result using that method, and then this is point is that so don't worry about this that solid lines. The just point is that experimental result, and then clearly see this as it's same as that the pictures, and then clearly see that the different forces between the different polarizations is, and then the large polarization gives a higher force. Also, the behavior is very different from that the low polarization case. Okay, we need to understand this behavior. So, and then before we just if we only considering that the elastic force, and then we cannot understand this behavior. And then the energy is that not only elastic term, we add the polarization and ionic scream term. So fortunately that Bob Meyer and then Zhong Feng Li, he calculate this polarization term, and then shows that increasing that kinematic polarization, there gives the increase in the band elastic constant. So that change that band elastic constant. So and then the previously they are all considered using that the elastic constant, and but we separate the two elastic constants and then change that the band elastic constant, and then we calculate the energy, and then we have a different kind of energies for different band elastic constants, and then the divergence of this energy we get the really nice force behavior between ions, and then this is that the now solid line is the peeling the experimental data using that simulation result. Then very well match with the simulation, but except this that the repulsive force. I think it is that in that calculation, the only considering that the long wavelength limit, but if you get closer and closer, then short wavelength limit is more important. So and then the theory is not matched very well. But overall, using the polarization term, we can explain that the experimental feature. Okay, and then another important thing is that as the Paul Myers group suggests that the effective band elasticity term is proportional to that polarization scale. And then we also experimentally measure the force as a function of the chirality percentage, which means is the chirality is proportional to the also polarization. So we is really clearly show that the force is proportional to that p squared term. So it's pretty well understood in chiral system. Okay, and then this is, and then I show different project. So another one is that so we have two different chirality. So we have the two different voltages look like same optically, but one is right-handed and left. One is left-handed, and then unlike the other dipolar interactions, it gives that quadrupolar interaction. And then we using the optical tweezers, and then we separate it there, and then we see, and then keep separating, and then the symmetry is breaking, and then the distance between that, the minus defect is also is the shape is also changed, right? So then this shows that the calculation is compared the blue dot is that green dot is carefully is experimental laser, and then the red line is that simulation laser. This is another application using the laser tracking method to understand that the dependent structures, also that the shape of the minus one defect, and this is the another example using the laser tweezers. And then this is also we have another example, as Kishan showed, that the two droplet and then making the coalescence dynamics. So in two-dimensional system we also do the same thing, right? So we are using the ACV Smectic films, and then in iron there has a electrostatic interaction between there, so always a gap between the two iron, and then using the tweezer and then change moving the stage to the right side, and then get closer and close, and then we get the coalescence and then making one dynamics. So also this is good example using the understanding the two dynamic coalescence dynamics using the laser tracking. Okay, so I make a conclusion. So in two-dimensional case, so if you want to track the disc-shaped island, so the tracking is only tracking force is maximized when when we illuminate the edge of the island. So this is the one the conclusion. And then second one, we measure the using this method, we measure the directly measure the interaction force between iron, and then shows that the polarization the effect gives that also increasing the band elastic constant, as we clearly explained that calculation, and then we show the experimentally, and then so and then lastly we show that the laser tracking is that also promising tool for studying the static and dynamics in two-dimensional crystal films. Thank you for your attention.
Okay, the session is now open for questions. Okay, I had a question.
Okay. So,
in one of your first slides, I thought the vertical axis on trapping force looked to be of order tens of picotons, perhaps.
Yeah.
And your measured force was significant. Yeah, go about that.
This one?
One more.
Oops. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah.
That one.
Oh, this one. Okay.
So it looks like the forces there are in tens of picotons, but the forces that you ended up measuring are
described
by femtonewtons. Do you know what the...
We still couldn't pick it up. Maybe the review is the chart. Yeah, PhD. After considering everything, we couldn't still figure out that why it has several difference. But experimentally, I think theoretically we don't understand exactly why there's always different. But experimentally, I think it's still we can use we can the correctly measure the forces, right?
Okay. So then,
if you have any comment or any idea to understand that would be great. But we still don't.
Okay. So my second question is the forces that you measure between the two interacting discs.
Uh-huh.
You know, it looks like you measure a negative force of about minus 2 femtonewtons, which, to my knowledge, is probably one of the smallest forces ever measured in an optical tracking setup.
Yeah.
How confident are you, like, in your hydrodynamic drag calculations that this is 2 femtonewtons and, let's say, not 15 or 20? Because people with optical traps, not correlation studies, but just straight force measurements, have measured down to, I think, we're back up 10 femtonewtons or something.
And
here you have something about 2 femtonewtons, which is an incredibly small force.
But still, I know that it's extremely small force, right? Like, now people want to make it's a femtonewton. But experimentally, really, it's confident that if you have a higher material, right? So force is really small, right? Elastic force is like that range of force, right? And then if you increase the higher, so that's why you cannot measure that the interaction force for the higher material. The elastic force is too small, right? And then if you add the polarization, and then the elastic force is getting bigger and bigger, right? And then finally you can measure that the force behavior. So I think it's very confident this force is correct. Yeah, that's really nice comment.
I think something to add to his answer. I think some of this boils down to how well you believe the Sapman theory for drag on a sphere is true. And the Smectic crystal obviously isn't an isotropic fluid, and there are some effects which aren't included in Sapman's paper. I mean, it's sort of a hard problem to solve. So I think, sort of in the back of our minds, there is a bit of uncertainty about the calibration.
Using that threading.
So there is some uncertainty, but not, free of this energy.
Right.
Can you produce ions with odd and even number of excess layers? And if so, there are any difference?
So I think we cannot just make the intentionally, right? But if you're making that tons of the island, right? Some of them is even air, some of them is older air. So, but you haven't worked on that. Any differences, different even layers or well. So I think that's a good suggestion. Maybe we'll try to work on that. The even or end layer gives different forces, right? So we haven't done it yet. Okay, thank you for that. The comment.
One last question.
Are there any thermal fluctuations in the system, or is it just so viscous?
There's a director fluctuations.
Sorry?
Director? We have a liquid crystal.
It's
small enough to diffuse.
Okay, then you don't need to use, as I discussed earlier, you don't need to use that window. You can just measure its fusion coefficient to figure out your hypermanipulability.
Yeah, for the, I think for the minus one defect, right? So then maybe you can use that the thermal fluctuation to calculate the fusion coefficient. But the island is really the large mass, and then the diffusion maybe the thermal fluctuation. Yeah, it doesn't change that much, right? We don't hardly see that the position changes, so, yeah.
Okay, so let's thank the speaker again. Thank you.